Good evening, all of you. So in today's class, we will see variable initialization, right? So we have to go to see the how can we initialize the variable. We have to understand it. So what is the meaning of this variable initialize? So initialization means what? We are going to something, put the values in the variable. That is the meaning of variable initialization. मतलब हम अगर देखिएगा सिंपल लैंग्वेज में अगर बात करें तो हमारे पास वेरिएबल वी नो दैट वेरिएबल इज द ब्लॉक ऑफ द मेमोरी. सो वी नो दैट दैट इज द वेरिएबल एंड इट्स अ ब्लॉक ऑफ आवर मेमोरी, राइट? एंड इन दैट ब्लॉक ऑफ मेमोरी आई वांट टू सम पुट द वैल्यूज इन दिस. एंड सपोज आई हैव द वेरिएबल नेम दैट इज अ ब्लॉक नेम ऑफ दिस पी एंड आई वांट टू इनिशियलाइज द सम वैल्यू, राइट? So I can initialize the sum value. That means I can store the sum value in this block of memory. Get it? That is the meaning of variable initialization. So suppose I am going to store the value like 9. So here I am going to store the value 9 in this. That means we are going to storing the value in the block of the memory. That means variable initialization. Now we are coming to the practical zone. And we will be understand how can we write the code, and then we will be understand in that depth. So we are coming to that part. We are taking the our project. So we are going to create a new project for C. Go to the create a new project. And in that moment, we are coming to the console application. Go. And we are going to the next. We are taking the C. नेक्स्ट को चूज करेंगे, प्रोजेक्ट का टाइटल देंगे. सो हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं इनिशियलाइजेशन की. सो मैं इनिट ए इनिट सॉरी फॉर दैट आई एम गिविंग द प्रोजेक्ट नेम इज इनिट ए, देन गो टू द नेक्स्ट एंड फिनिश. नाउ इट्स आवर कोड इज जनरेटेड बट वी हैव टू सी हियर. सो व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डू, सॉरी फॉर दिस इंटरप्शन, वी आर कमिंग टू दिस पार्ट. आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू मूव फॉर वन मिनट, दिस व्हाई इज नॉट मूविंग दिस वन. We are coming to this part here, and in the init, this is our project name on the code block ID, and this is our sources folder. So in that folder, we'll be expand this one, and we'll be go to the main.c file, right? We'll be come here and see. This is our code of the C will be already mentioned by the code block. This frame is already available. So today, what are we going to do? We are going to take means initialize the value in the variable. So how can we initialize the variable? So write at here I am going to write like I am taking the one data type that is the int. We know that for the integer type, and one variable I am taking the p. And if you want to initialize the variable, so just use the operator, assignment operator, right? So here that assignment operator I am going to use and writing the value what I want to assign to the p. So I am going to assign the 9, right? So that means we are going to, if I'm not using to like this one, that means what is happening here, understand, in this block, there is no any value, right? So that is a no any value in this block. That's meaning of this. That is the meaning of our variable declaration. So in previous class, I told you that is the meaning of variable declaration, right? 1 minute for that, so many crowd is coming. So that is the part of our variable declaration here, right? So here we are going to understand that means sorry for that, what is happening here, one more things here, okay, right? So this is a variable declaration means whatever I retain the code in there, that means in the block no any value is here, ready? So that means we have the code and in that we have the no any values, clear? That is the meaning of int p. If I'm just using the like going to store the value, so we'll be use the assignment operator and write the value is a 9. So what I'm going to do, I am going to store the value 9 inside the p. I'm going to store, that means 9 is going to assign onto the p variable. That means what is happening in the inner side of the memory side, we will see in the inner side in the p block of the memory, we are going to store the value 9. That is going to be stored here, right? In that part. That is the meaning of variable initialization. Now we are coming to the part. Suppose I something done here, and thus I'm going to move to this part. And we are coming to the, I want to print to data, right? So I will use, we know that in the C programming, we use the printf function, right? For printing some data on the screen. So you will use the double quote, and in double quote, you will be must specify the format specifier, right? So here format specifier, I'm giving the modulus t. That means for the integer, I am giving that, right? This is a format specifier, this entire thing. This is the modulus and t, d for the integer. Now in the double quote, you go for the separate comma will be give, right? Comma is there, and just write the name of the variable. This is the p. And now I am going to like that. That is a semicolon is for the terminate statement. I want to run and see the output. So what output will become? The value of p will become. What is the value of p? 9. That's the output will be the come. Now we have to see. We are going to the build, compile and run that project. So see that. So it's taking this going to compile. It's taking the same time. It's coming right now. Is that? Yeah. This. This 9 output is coming here, right? 9 is coming on our screen. That means what is happening? We are storing the value to initialize. That is the meaning of our initialization of the variable, right? Now we will be come to the next moment. Here we have to understand that is the for the integer part. If I am taking the like here float, for example, I am taking the float data, right? Float data type. So we know that float is always giving the decimal numbers. What I'm going to do, I'm going to write 9.56. So after decimal, I am going to use the decimal number is a 56. Getting a point? So that means what is happening here? Hum log decimal ko do digit de rahe, but float kya karega? Jab hum output dekhenge, to decimals after decimal, it will allow up to 6 digit. Getting a point? So here I have to also change the format specifier. A specifier for float, I will give the f. Now if I'm giving the f and I want to print the value of p, that what is happening, you have to see. Now you are going to the build again and run, and we will be take this, just see that after decimal it will allow the 6 digit. We given the 9.56, so after that 0 is automatic replaces by the compiler. That is the meaning of float. Getting my point? So, अगर हम देखेंगे कि अगर फ्लॉट देते हैं डेटा तो डेसिमल नंबर को अलाउ करता है, लेकिन ये ध्यान रखना है कि डेसिमल के बाद 6 डिजिट ही अलाउ होता है फ्लॉट में. और फ्लॉट के लिए जो हम फॉर्मेट स्पेसिफायर यूज करते हैं वो मॉडुलस एफ यूज करते हैं. अब हम चलते हैं नेक्स्ट सिक्स तरफ. मैं आपको फ्लॉट और डबल में मैं डिफरेंस समझा रहा हूँ. वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द फ्लॉट एंड डबल डेटा टाइप, एंड सेम कॉन्सेप्ट वी आर गोइंग टू यूज फॉर द इनिशियलाइज द वेरिएबल. तो यहाँ पर मैं क्या कर रहा हूँ, अब मैं फ्लॉट की जगह मैं डबल डेटा को यूज कर रहा हूँ, डबल डेटा टाइप्स को. ठीक है, नाउ अब इज वैल्यू इज सेम थिंग इज गोइंग टू असाइन. मैं यहाँ पर 9.56 ही असाइन कर रहा हूँ इस पर, पी पर इनिशियलाइज कर रहा हूँ. जब हम डबल ए लेंगे ना, तो यहाँ पर जो हमारा फॉर्मेट स्पेसिफायर होगा वो मॉडुलस एल एफ हो जाएगा. क्लियर है? मॉडुलस एल एफ. गेटिंग ए पॉइंट? एंड इन दैट वी आर गोइंग टू प्रिंट द वैल्यू ऑफ द पी. तो देखिए, जब डबल में फ्लॉट में भी डेसिमल और डबल में भी डेसिमल, बट डिफरेंस क्या होगा कि आफ्टर डेसिमल ये 15 डिजिट अलाउ करता है डबल डेटा, बट फ्लॉट वही क्या करता है कि आफ्टर डेसिमल 6 डिजिट अलाउ करेगा. ये डिफरेंस होता है दोनों में. वन मोर थिंग, डबल डेटा का जो साइज होता है वो 8 बाइट होता है, जबकि फ्लॉट का कितना होगा, 4 बाइट होगा. दैट इज द वन मोर डिफरेंस. सो वी आर गोइंग टू कंपाइल एंड रन एंड वी सी द आउटपुट. व्हाट इज द आउटपुट इज कमिंग, एंड दैट इज द गो टू द प्रैक्टिकल जोन. नाउ सी, 1 minute. That's why it's coming to the 336. 1 minute. Modulus. Oh, this one is giving the something like modulus LF we are going to use. So that's why it's coming to get some problems. Don't worry, we'll be understand here. So this is that's the compiler is coming to the taking the same things. We are going to assign like 10.45. Now we are going to the build. First, it will go to the build, compile that first, right? And we are going to compile. Compiler is going to compile to this process. Compilation is happening. Now we are going to run. That is 10.450336. So that's a GNU-CC compiler is here. That's why it's not giving. If another compiler, if you are going to use, after decimal, it will allow to the up to 50 digit, right? This is the our दैट इज द होल कंक्लूजन ऑफ द इनिशियलाइजेशन ऑफ वेरिएबल. सो मैं आपको सिंपल सा बोलूं कि इनिशियलाइजेशन ऑफ वेरिएबल क्या होता है, कि हम अगर वैल्यू मेमोरी ब्लॉक में स्टोर कर रहे हैं, इनिशियलाइज कर रहे हैं, मतलब वी आर गोइंग टू स्टोर द वैल्यू इन द मेमोरी ब्लॉक. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ वेरिएबल इनिशियलाइजेशन. सो आई होप टुडे योर क्लास इज एंजॉयिंग दैट एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर टुडे. विल बी गो टू द फर्दर डिस्कशन इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. थैंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू. So just wait of the little bit moment. We are coming on the next moment. Okay. Just go to that. And that's it. Sorry for that. What we have. We are coming to this moment. I'm just going to this section. Right. Yeah. This one. And that's it.